Doctor Who wouldn't be Doctor Who without the iconic Sonic Screwdriver. And for so long, only the Doctor was allowed to have the Space Swiss Army Knife. The Master had a laser screwdriver, and Sarah Jane had a Sonic lipstick. But still, nobody was ever important enough to have another Sonic screwdriver, especially a Sonic screwdriver given to them by the Doctor. That changed when the Doctor met River Song. Hi everyone, it's Zephyr's Voice, and welcome to Tardis Central. If you want to keep up to date on all the latest Doctor Who news, lore, and more, then make sure to hit that subscribe button to never miss a video from the team here at Tardis Central. You can also follow us on social media for daily updates on the Doctor Who universe. As always, please let us know your thoughts in the comments section below, because if you're talking about Doctor Who, then we want to hear about it. When the 10th Doctor meets the archaeologist known as Professor River Song in the library, it's the first time he's come across River, but she has lived her whole life knowing the Doctor. It's a huge curveball to have a character who knows so much about the Doctor, and the fact she has her own Sonic screwdriver only makes it clear to the Doctor, and us, just how important she is. The first time the Doctor sees River's Sonic screwdriver, he just says, "What's that?" And she replies, "It's a screwdriver." To which he says, "It's Sonic?" And River shakes that off with, "Yeah, I know, snap." When River reveals her Sonic to the Doctor, she tells him about its red setting and dampers, which he claims don't exist, only to be proven wrong. At the end of the episode, Forest of the Dead, the Doctor realizes that it had also been fitted with a neural relay that allows River's data ghost to be uploaded into the library data core after her tragic demise. It's a genius twist of fate that a future Doctor, who we won't see for quite some time, is responsible for protecting River and leaving the means for her happy ending, so to speak, in the hands of his past self. Just before River's death, she tells the Doctor that he turned up on her doorstep with a haircut and a new suit and took her to the Singing Towers of Deryllium, where he gave her his Sonic. She says that should have been a clue that it was the last time they would meet while knowing each other. It's a painful, haunting scene that plays on the love River feels for the Doctor, and he still has no idea who she is. Following this meeting with Ten, River has many adventures with multiple Doctors across TV, audio, and comics. When we reach the episode, The Husbands of River Song, with the 12th Doctor, we finally see the moment when River is given the Sonic. 12 turns up with his haircut and new suit, and after manipulating events thanks to time travel, he takes River on the most beautiful and impressive date of all time at the Singing Towers of Deryllium. It's a heartbreaking scene that brings their relationship full circle and ruined Christmas Day 2015 for Doctor Who fans by leaving us all in floods of tears. We know that this is their final meeting, and what to expect. When the Doctor gives River the Sonic, she claims it's the first present he's ever given her. This is one of the most painful things we'll ever see in Doctor Who, made even worse by how River doesn't quite realise what this means at the moment, but we as viewers do. When River said that this night at Deryllium was her last meeting with the Doctor, it would appear that she learned a few tricks from her husband. As she learned a long time ago, he lies, and so does she. Between Deryllium and the library, there were a couple of adventures where River bumped into the Doctor, but had to keep her identity a secret. These adventures take place over the Doom Coalition audios. Her first appearance in this series is a second series story, The Sonomancer, where River worked alongside the Doctor's companion, Helen Sinclair, to save the natives of the planet Syra. The Sonic came in handy for all the usual reasons. She even tells Helen that it's better than the Doctor's, and Helen ends up keeping her meeting with River quiet, to protect the Doctor from any knowledge of her. River later appears in the 8th piece, The Doomsday Chronometer, The Crucible of Souls from Doom Coalition 3, and Songs of Love from Doom Coalition 4. All of that takes place between the end of The Husbands of River Song and Silence in the Library. So, we know River was incredibly special to be given the Sonic screwdriver, and we know the Sonic itself is special with its neural relay, dampers, and red setting. But how does it work? Peter McKinstry's concept art gives us a perfect look at this unique Sonic in great detail, with all the details labelled. It's close in design to the 10th Doctor's Sonic, with small additions and changes. In a way, it raises the question of whether the Doctor did that to avoid spoilers for his future Sonics, which would become more and more intricate for 11 and 12. So, for this special version, let's start at the bottom and work our way up. The bottom has a felt tip cap. Odd, but quirky. It's also a handy pen. Someone on the TARDIS Central team had a 10th Doctor Sonic screwdriver pen when they were younger. We'll let you figure out who that might have been. Next, we come to setting the dials. Underneath the setting dials is the user recognition ring. River's little finger goes through that loop when she holds it, making it easier for her to spin it around in her hands and look cool. A fluid link links the user recognition ring to a TARDIS remote return button. This fluid link is separate from the main body of the Sonic. The main body does extend, though we don't see that happen in any televised story. On the top of the main body, we have the master function key, which can be removed to reveal the neural relay device. Finally, the Sonic tip is fitted with wave amplifiers and an enhanced emitter lens. In a 2011 interview with Geek Filter, prop maker Nick Roberto explained River's Sonic screwdriver prop was made from brass, nylon with an aluminium body, with some resin on it and some acrylic paint. He shows that the Sonic has a main light on the end, but inside the hidden neural relay can be changed, so it goes from all bars flashing down to just one. Despite the Sonic screwdriver being so unique and important, in a recent interview for Big Finish, Alex Kingston answered fan questions and asked, "Which of River's gadgets would you most like to own in real life?" Alex replied, "Well, that's actually quite tough, because I do like gardening, so a Sonic Trowel could come in handy. But at the same time, I like a vortex manipulator." So after all the trouble the Doctor goes through to give her a proper Sonic screwdriver to replace the Sonic Trowel that he calls embarrassing, she'd still rather have the Trowel. Some food for thought, I guess. River did have a Sonic Trowel, in case you didn't know. Naturally, this device helped her in the adventures as an archaeologist. She used it in an excavation site in 1924, and then on a mission to the lost world of the Liparia. We're more familiar with the use of the Sonic Trowel during the Husbands of River Song episode. It was notable when River used it to stun King Hydroflax's warrior monk bodyguards, but sadly, the king himself was ineffective again due to his robot suit. The 12th Doctor would recommend the idea of a Sonic Trowel was embarrassing, as we mentioned above. Though this comment comes from a man who had Sonic sunglasses, so, you know. Sadly, there's not much information on River Song's Sonic screwdriver. It's a unique piece of equipment she ends up with in the Doctor Who universe. Perhaps, if we ever get that River Song spin-off series that many fans have been hoping for, then there's a chance we'll see her use the iconic Sonic screwdriver once again. Ah, we can dream. So what do you think of River Song's Sonic screwdriver? Let us know what you think in the video comment section below, because if you're talking about Doctor Who, then we want to hear about it. If you want to keep up to date on all the latest Doctor Who news, lore and more, then make sure to hit that subscribe button to never miss a video from the team here at TARDIS Central. You can also follow us on social media for daily updates on the Doctor Who universe. That's it from TARDIS Central. I've been ZephyrsVoice. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.